Welcome to Scriptcase. My name is Jamie Oates, and I'm your host during this demonstration. So what is Scriptcase? What's it all about? And how can it help us with our development chores? Scriptcase is a truly efficient development low-code platform. It not only helps us with the creation of complete web systems, but it also allows us to include business intelligence within our applications. And it does this quite fast, while being very easy to use. We have a rapidly growing community since we started in 2006 with over 1,000 orders. We have since then grown to over 89,000 orders this year alone, meaning that more and more people are using our platform for their project creations. And since we began back in 2006, we have released 9 versions to date, with the next one already in the pipeline. With over 1 million live projects and over 45,000 developers in more than 150 countries, Scriptcase is used in communities, universities, organizations, and businesses around the globe, increasing its user basis with each new release. And it is no surprise that more and more people are using it today, as with every new release, Scriptcase comes with some amazing new features and gets easier and easier to use. Scriptcase is based on and fully supports the PHP, JavaScript, HTML5, jQuery, and CSS programming languages within its development environment. It also includes web components, which help us to connect to external web services or APIs. Just because it is based on PHP, for example, all applications are created and customized with a few clicks of a mouse, providing a simple and rapid way to create our projects. However, for advanced platforms and customizations, knowledge of PHP may be required. Using Scriptcase for our projects can help us rapidly create powerful RAD systems, which can include complete authentication with groups, single users, and even LDAP systems. The security system is quite complete, which creates all pages required to manage your platform users and applications, including a security logging system, all fully integrated within our own project. We also have available the typical applications which we would create, such as the grid, form, chart, or dashboard applications, all with the ability to connect with various social platforms built in, allowing us to quickly add Facebook or Google authentication to our projects. To help us manage and speed up our development, we also have many project management development abilities built into Scriptcase, enabling team and group project development with full team management abilities, messaging, and project tasks manager. We also have a full-fledged database manager, including SQL console abilities, built into Scriptcase, negating the need for external applications or database management. And of course, we do have the choice of using any other database editor we please at the same time without any issues. If you wanted to import external libraries into your project, we can. And if you wanted to write your own, then you can also do so. With internal and external libraries, we can add just about anything from an outside source that uses PHP and use it within our own projects. But wait, if you thought that was all, within Scriptcase, we will also find an integrated IDE, which includes many functional features, only speeding up our development time even further, with modern themes, editors, code templates, and also code snippets. We can prepare our personal styles and business intelligence codes, save and apply them to any application or project, and then even reuse them anywhere in Scriptcase that includes the code editor. Using Scriptcase opens a world of possibilities when it comes to platform development. It's always fresh with updates and improvements to the development environment, its features, as well as its own abilities. And one important note I should make is that the migration from older versions is smooth as silk, allowing you to apply those new updates and features to your existing projects with some clicks and possibly simple adjustments. We have a collection of templates, themes, buttons, and images available to use as they are, or to customize and import into your own projects, including font awesome icon support for buttons and so forth. Deploying Scriptcase applications is a breeze. With the rapid deployment features, we can get our projects live with a few clicks of the mouse, regardless if to a local drive, the network, or even to the cloud. Nothing complicated, it can be as simple as a click and deploy. And before I forget about the world, the main interface comes in 9+ different languages, and that's only for the Scriptcase development interface itself. as we can apply as many languages as we want within our own projects, where we also have 50 plus languages already provided in those languages for the standard applications, saving us not only development time, but also on translation costs. Scriptcase and projects developed with it are all browser friendly. They work with any operating system and device, and we have full support for various databases as well as web or hosting services such as Apache or Nginx, allowing us to deploy not only our web developed projects, but also our Scriptcase development environment live online, which in turn provides easy access for team and group project development. With Scriptcase hosted online, using it in teams or groups is also a breeze, as we can use Scriptcase live online or within a grouped network where all developers can access the same development environment as a team or group with any browser, device or operating system on the market today. Within our projects, we can have multiple developers work on a single project or even multiple projects at the same time, with the ability to communicate and create project tasks for each other within Scriptcase. And when it comes to the workflow of our projects, as an individual or as a group, we can integrate new additions, updates, and changes to our projects and applications, which we have developed continuously during the entire evolution of our platform. As with most web projects, we start by creating a project connection, which can be a local or remote server, flesh out and build up our project applications and code, test it locally, and then deploy it to a live server. Once deployed, we can update our entire project or individual applications with ease from within the Scriptcase development environment without the need for any other complicated FTP applications. With Scriptcase, you can make your projects come to life, from project initiation and approval to final completion and deployment. No matter if you are a man or woman with a project idea, individual developer, or a team or group of developers or businesses, try Scriptcase yourself today, or after watching this demo, of course, and begin to create your own projects with our free 20-day trial. You can install it locally and be set and be ready to begin developing your own projects today. So let's check out the Scriptcase.net website, check out some of the online content we have available, and download a fresh installation so that we can get started using Scriptcase once you are ready. On our website, we use the top main menu and select download, and then download again. From the download page, we can select the version of Scriptcase we want to use, depending on your own operating system. At the top, it should be automatically indicated, and you should be able to download the version indicated directly. Below the alternative versions, if you want to download Scriptcase for a different operating system, and below that, we also have some manual installation options. The manual installation options do require you to have an environment already set up. As it says here, if you already have Apache, PHP 7, and Source Guardian, that fits the requirements. Please do follow the instructions if you require any help. Once you have selected the download button, you will be requested to either download with Facebook, Google, or provide an email address. Once you have entered your email address or selected the download with Google or Facebook, we can select the download button and the web browser will download the latest version of Scriptcase. We can select to save or save as. We can also run the Scriptcase installation directly if we so choose. But before we continue with the installation and check out some of the applications within Scriptcase, let's continue with what we have available on the Scriptcase.net website. So the first option in the top menu is Features. Within the Features section, we get a view of what is possible within Scriptcase. We will be covering most of that as we will continue during this demo. So I won't spend much time on this page, but you can of course go ahead and check out some of the options that we have available. The next option available is Samples. Now I will open samples within a new tab. Within the sample section, we can check out the available systems that we can build within Scriptcase and that are also available to use within our own projects or to be used as a basis as a project. We can also see the various form types and see what each of them look like. For instance, here we have a master detail form. We can also view various reports, chart examples, dashboard examples. Here we have a dashboard passing parameters, for instance, the chart application. Within the sample section, we can check out each of the available options and take our time doing so. Everything that we see here, we are also able to build and replicate within Scriptcase with ease. The next option within the Scriptcase.net website is the e-learning. Within the e-learning menu option, we will find options for webinars, courses, documentation, videos, as well as our blog. Within each of these sections, we will find a wealth of information, for instance, on the webinars, the courses, documentation, and videos. If I open each one of these, we can see within the webinars page that we have many webinars which you are able to register and sign up for. Within the courses section, we are able to sign up for specific Scriptcase courses. Within the documentation, we are able to view the documentation online, download a PDF or a zip format. Opening the online documentation, we can view a great deal of information regarding Scriptcase should we need to. We will find everything we need here regarding macros that we can use within Scriptcase, the applications, connections, and so forth. Within videos, we will find many videos which will help us on our first steps within Scriptcase, how we can develop forms, applications, and provide advanced programming. Back to the top menu, we also have support. We can access our support, and from within support, we are able to open the ticket system and view tickets which we have opened, or ask questions to the support team. We also have a live chat available where we can talk to Scriptcase specialists, which will help us with our questions. Within the facts section, we also have many questions and responses which will help you further. Within support, the forum can provide us a great deal of information. Performing a search here will help us in many of our questions. So once we've decided to invest in our own license, we can first select the duration, lifetime or annual. Then we have the available license options, being Starter, Professional, or Enterprise, each of which include their own perks and may not be required by all users. For instance, the Starter license can be used with specific databases, as indicated here, whereas the Enterprise version can work with just about all databases, including Sybase, Informix, and ODBC. The Starter and Professional license options are also designed for single developers, where the Enterprise version is for group or team development orientation, providing extra features for team project development, as well as the ability to allow multiple developers to use the environment at the same time. To the top here, we can also see the support options, where we can see what support packages are available and select to include one with our license on purchase. In most cases, we will find all the help and support we need on the forum or within the available documentation and videos. To the bottom, we also have a FAQ which will help you with any questions or doubts you may have. To the top again, we also have a tab where we can renew our license or upgrade it. And then the final tab, which is the Scriptcase hosting. This is fully optional and is not a requirement. It does, however, allow a great deal of convenience considering the need to set up a database possibly, as well as being able to access your development environment from wherever you are in the world and from any device. As we have seen online, we have a wealth of information available to us, from master courses to webinars, from application examples to full systems which we can test online before we create, import, and learn from them. We also have a growing community within our forum and a complete FAQ available with all relevant details available should you need. If you want, of course, you can always sign up for one of our free webinars and learn something new about a specific topic, and even ask your questions directly to a Scriptcase employee. So let's go ahead and dive into Scriptcase, log in, and register our platform for the very first time. Before we begin, let me point out though that we are first using a clean installation of Windows with nothing else installed other than the latest Windows updates and the Scriptcase installation, as nothing else is required for us to use and run the Scriptcase development environment. Okay, so now let's go ahead and check out the Scriptcase login page and discuss a little about what is going on and what is available for us as a first-time user during the trial period of using the Scriptcase platform. On the login screen for the first time and during the trial period, we will see first of all our login details. This is not displayed after our first login, as well as the period remaining for our trial period. Okay, so we log in with the default username, admin, and password as indicated here. And we can go ahead and enter that. But before we do so, let me highlight also that we can access a forgot password option if we are using an online version of Scriptcase or as a group access for a group development. Next up, we then also have the option to change our language. If we want to change from English to German, French, Japanese, Italian, Russian, then we can do so, and it will change the development language or the development environment language of Scriptcase. So now let's go ahead and log in for the very first time. Okay, when accessing Scriptcase for the very first time on a fresh installation or a new browser, as well as a clean computer where we have not allowed pop-ups for our local host already, the web browser may request that we enable pop-ups for the 127.0.0.1 domain, which is our local host. We will enable that so that we enable the mini little Scriptcase window, which pops up every so often and provides us information. Okay, so next up we have, for the very first time and only presented on first login, the thank you for your time evaluating Scriptcase, as well as an indication of our chat button, which is located bottom right here. And we can click this and we will have the option to chat with our support team. From here, we can access the support team, ask our questions, confirm any doubts we have within Scriptcase during the trial period. Once Scriptcase has been licensed or the trial period has expired, this option will no longer be available. Okay, so now let's select OK, got it, and we will be taken to the Scriptcase dashboard for the very first time. The top right here, you may notice straight away, we have the option of check the get started video, which is actually this video you are watching right now. So let's select OK, got it, and remove that for the time being. Okay, as this is a clean installation and we have not any license yet, we will also want to go ahead and do that. So we can access our options within the top menu, and we can also go ahead and access the settings option. From here, we can then go to the online registration. We can add our Scriptcase username and password, which is what we use online, and then also the serial number. Once we have the serial number entered, we can click the register button and Scriptcase will be registered. If by chance you have a failure message, you also have an offline request. So from here, again, we can add our details, our username and password, enter the Scriptcase license key, and then we can request to download a specific key. This key we can then use within the offline registration. Again, we add our username and password, enter our key, and upload the file which we have received, and click register. In most scenarios, this will solve most registration issues. As we continue within this demo, we will be seeing how to create a project, get an overview of all the applications available, how to finally add authentication and platform security with ease to then launch or deploy our project to a live hosted environment. Thank you very much for watching part one of this Scriptcase demonstration. I hope to see you again soon in the next part, part two. Thank you for watching.